Praise Yeshua. First and foremost, I would like to thank my Father in Heaven for giving me this opportunity to stand and testify of His love and also for His goodness that I'm standing here. I would also like to thank Pastor Jones Joseph and Sister Shirmily Jones for giving me an opportunity to share the word with the people who are, you know, the members of the channel Christ Vision. So I hope as I stand here and share the word, Yeshua will touch those hearts who need strength, who are looking up to Him for help, who are, there are many of them who are listening to me today who don't even know that there is help available for them. So even before we get into the word, there's nothing that we can do without getting into His presence. And there's nothing more beautiful than His presence. But to get into His presence, the most easiest and the best way is to worship. The thing is, without You, Holy Spirit, I cannot do anything. Without Your presence, I cannot do anything. So can we just spend a few minutes in worship, glorify Him, and ask heavens to come down and to touch the people. Yes, can we just get into His presence? Can we sing a very famous old song that says, You are my strength when I am weak. You are the treasure that I seek. Seeking You as a precious, precious jewel. Not to give up, I will be a fool. No matter what all we give up in this life, there is one thing that holds us back, and that is the love of our Maker. Can we just bow our heads in His presence? And can we ask the Holy Spirit to strengthen us as we get into His presence? Laying aside everything, laying aside our burdens, laying aside things that pull us back into the world. Can we just go back and declare again that Your strength, Your grace, O Lamb of God, is enough for me. Yes, let's just worship Him. Can you just stand up wherever you are and can you just worship with me? Yes. Yeah, let's worship.
Give Thank you, Yeshua. Thank you, Yeshua, for all that you have done in our life. Thank you for your goodness and for your mercy. That irrespective of what happened in our lives, irrespective of how many times we fell away from your presence, irrespective of how many times we forgot you, we just want to say thank you, thank you, thank you from the depth of our heart for being so good and for being so merciful. Father, as we enter the time of word, Holy Spirit, I pray that let your goodness and let your mercy flow into the lives of every person who is viewing me at this point. And not me, Yeshua, not me, but let you and your Holy Spirit work in the lives of your children who need you, Father, who need your touch. I pray that let your words of encouragement flow into the lives of these children, Father. They are looking up to you. Your sheep is looking up to you. They're calling to their shepherd. Oh, my good shepherd, would you just enter their lives and heal what needs to be healed, build what needs to be built. Father, build the broken walls, build broken relationships, heal bodies and lives, strengthen those who are weak, fill those who are thirsty. Yes, Father, I pray for your mercy and for your grace to abound in the lives of your children. I'm just a mere voice, Father, but Holy Spirit, I pray that you attest my voice, that it will reach out to every person who needs you, who needs you, who is looking up to you. Thank you, Father, for doing it. Thank you, Yeshua. Thank you, Yeshua. Thank you, Yeshua. In Yeshua's name we pray, amen and amen. I believe that as we are doing this, Yeshua has been looking at us and he is going to work a miracle in your life. I want to declare over your lives today that as you listen to his word, as you listen to his word, your life is going to change drastically. Your things that are pulling you back into depression, into worry, is going to be removed from your life today. That you are going to take off your sackcloth. You are going to take off your mourning cloth. And you are going to come out as victorious in the name of Yeshua. That is the prophetic word over your life, my brother, my sister. Yeshua is going to do a miracle in your life because he loves you. Simple thing, he loves you the way you are, the way you have been. In spite of everything, he cares for you. He loves you. He cares for you. Can you just take it at my word? Not my word, but his word. He says, I will never leave you nor forsake you. When he says this, he is not a man to lie, but he is a God who is true to his promises. Many men came into your life, many women came into your life, but nobody stood by you. But this God, who is not a man, tells you that he will never leave you nor forsake you, and he is true to your promise. No matter what situation you are in today, I want to declare over your life that get up from that place of depression. Get up from that place where you think that I cannot move anymore. Yes, I declare in the prophetic realm, there is going to be a shift in your life today. Because no one else than Yeshua has entered your household. Because you are listening to his word, Yeshua's presence is entering your life. Would you just receive that in the name of Yeshua? I praise you, Yeshua. Let me just take the word that I have for you today. What Yeshua has put in my heart is Isaiah 52. Let me read what he's telling you. This is the prophetic word over your life. It says, awake, awake, O Zion. Clothe yourself with strength. Put on your garments of splendor, O Jerusalem, the holy city. The uncircumcised and the defiled will not enter you again. Shake off your dust. Rise up. Sit enthroned, O Jerusalem. Free yourself from the chains on your neck, O captive daughter of Zion. For this is what the Lord says. You were sold for nothing, and without money you will be redeemed. This is the word over your life, my dear brother, my dear sister, today. And each and every word is a prophecy over your life. It is a prophecy over your life. What is a prophecy? Prophecy is about your future. It is talking about your future, what is going to come into your life. And when I say this, I am not saying anything out of this world. I am talking to you about what is there in the word and what Yeshua, the Holy Spirit, is going to do in your life. Would you just be willing to receive it in the name of Yeshua? Even if you are not a Christian, even if you have never heard a preaching, even if you don't know any of it, today I want you to know that irrespective of your caste, irrespective of your creed, irrespective of your gender, irrespective of your position in the society, Yeshua loves you and He wants to put this word into your life. Let me just read it again. It says, awake, awake, O Zion, clothe yourself with strength. Now He says, awake, awake. Now, many a times when we have issues in our life, you know, personally, when I feel low, even though now with all the responsibilities, even when I'm tired, I get up and I do things. But there was a time, like, you know, before getting married, when I didn't have much responsibilities on me, if I would be worried, what I will do is, I will just go back to my bed, I'll cover myself, I might cry for some time, but I would just sleep. I will just sleep, or I will just be upset thinking that nothing is going to change for me. So there would be, you know, that the state of depression is mostly when we don't feel like standing up. When we feel like, you know, I just want to lie down, I just want to cry, my body posture changes, my shoulders stoop, my back bends, I just don't want to stand, I want to sit somewhere, I want to lean on something. That is the position of depression. That is the position of sadness. That is the position of sorrow. And here it says, awake, awake, O Zion, clothe yourself with strength. And when in this state of worry or depression or anxiety, when we are in that state, a friend comes. She says, get up, my friend. Get up from whatever you're feeling. Get up. You know, so I have friends in my life who tell me, you know, I have a close friend. She tells me whenever I'm low, she always tells me, can you just go and change, take a bath, feel fresh, get a new dress on, put some, you know, you make yourself feel good and just go out for a walk. And many a times that have worked in my life where I just got up, I'll just get up, I'll dress up and I'll go out. And when the breeze touches my body, when it touches my face, I feel that Yeshua made all these things for me. Suddenly I'm reminded of how beautiful He has created everything. And isn't that to make me feel good? So here also it is saying, awake, awake, O Zion, clothe yourself with strength. So I want to tell you today, just like my friend comes to me and tells me, get up, Raji. Get up from the place where you are feeling low. I want to tell you, my brother and sister, awake. You are sleeping today. You are sleeping thinking that nothing is going to change for you. Your situations are, you know, irrevocable. You cannot do anything about it. Is what is the lie of the Satan. The evil one is telling you that things are not going to change. But in the name of Yeshua, can you rebuke him? Can you just tell him, get away with your lies, devil. I am not going to listen to it. I know my Maker's word, and it says, awake, awake. My dear brother and sister, I want you to get up. I want you to get up from that place of depression, of worry, of anxiety today, and clothe yourself with strength. I know you don't have enough strength in your body. I know you do not have enough strength in your heart. I know your circumstances are telling you that your situations are not going to change. But that is why I'm speaking to you today. Yes, I am speaking to you today because Yeshua wants you to get up. Awake, awake. Get up from your sleep. Get up from the lies that you're living in. Get up from that sleep which puts you into, a state where you don't do anything thinking that nothing is going to work. But this day, Yeshua's voice is reaching your household that you will get up and that you will clothe yourself with strength. In some time, I'm going to pray for you. In few minutes from now, I'm going to pray for you. But before that, I want your heart to receive it. I want your heart to be awake in the name of Yeshua. Let the spirit be awake. Let this person's spirit be awake. Father, the one who is crying out to you, Lord, let this person's spirit be awake, oh Father. Yes, Yeshua, let your spirit be awake. Yes, Master, do it because you are a good Father. Yes, awake, awake from your sleep, from your nothingness and from your emptiness. Yeshua's light is coming to your house. Let us read what it says further. Put on your garments of splendor, O Jerusalem, the holy city. The uncircumcised and the defiled will not enter you again. Okay? So it says, put on the garments of splendor. Now, again, let's just go back to the same position. The times when you don't feel good, you don't feel like dressing up, right? And maybe the dress that you've been wearing yesterday, you don't want to change it even. You don't want to get up. I remember the day when my father passed away. I was just 13 years old. And that day, that morning, early morning, I was preparing for my unit test. And I was, it was getting cold. So I took one of my father's sweater and I started to study. When I hear my mother's voice crying out on that road at night, they were bringing my father's body from the hospital and I could hear her cry from far away. And when they got him to the house, we were all heartbroken. My mom was crying. And she would just go unconscious in between. My brothers were too small to understand what was happening. And everybody would come back and tell me, don't cry, Raji. If you cry, who is going to look after your brothers? Who is going to look after your mother? So at that young age, I felt, okay, there's not a lot of responsibility on my body, but on me. But then I would think every time, how do I get up? Many times I would feel so low and I would feel that is, my life has come to an end. We don't have anybody to protect us. The father in the house is not there. We don't have anybody to feed us. We don't have anybody to come and stand and protect us. I would feel so low. And that's when, it says that we don't feel like doing anything. We just want to lie down. We don't want to change our clothes. We don't want to eat. So that day, because all the rituals and things were happening, one of my neighbors took me to their house and they wanted me to eat something because I didn't eat anything. I remember the food was on the table, she put it and it was good food. But I could not take a piece of food to my mouth. I could not eat because I was so burdened in my heart. When the chechi stopped, when she moved to another room, I went out and in the backyard, I threw all the food. Because my spirit was so burdened, thinking that I don't have a protector now. I don't have anybody to protect me. I don't have anybody to cover me. I don't have anybody to love me. Yes, my mother and my brothers are there, but I looked up to my father for that. Now where is he? That was the state. And perhaps this is the state of many of you. Here the word says, put on your garments of splendor, O Jerusalem, the holy city. So I want you to take this as a prophetic word over your life today. Put on the garments of splendor. nor the splendor is not going to come to you from any human being. Nobody can do that. That is the reality. My earthly father left us when we were very young, and I thought we will not be able to move ahead in my life. But I tell you, his eyes were looking at me at the age of 17 in an unexpected situation when I never thought the Savior came into my life. He was already there in my life, but it was just that time that I met the lover of my soul and my life changed. And it is only after he came into my life that everything changed. The sorrow, the pain, the sickness, the worry, the anxiety that you're wearing today and sleeping, I want you to get up from that place today. I want you to be awake from that place, and I want you to wear the clothes of splendor. The splendor of Yeshua, the splendor of His love, the splendor of His mercies, the splendor of His joy. I am not talking about anything that I have not seen. Yes, I have not seen Him with my open eyes, but I tell you, every breath of mine is a miracle. Everything that I do is a miracle for me. Every breath of yours is a miracle. And He has put His Holy Spirit inside you. Can you just look into your heart today? Can you just peep into your heart today? His eyes are looking at you. His eyes are looking at you, my dear. And He wants to do a miracle in your life today. Only thing He's asking you is, in your spirit, get up. Be awake. Awake. Open your eyes. Open your eyes. Do not be in the sleep. Get up, open your eyes, wash your face, open your eyes to the truth of the blood of Christ, open your eyes to the truth that Yeshua died for you on the cross and He was resurrected, and with His resurrection, His life is going to come to you and to your household. Wash your face, wash your body, cleanse your life with the blood of Yeshua. He wants to wash away your sins, He wants to wash away your sickness, He wants to wash away anything and everything that has been disturbing you and putting you down in that pit. Get up, awake, open your eyes and wash yourself. His blood and His word is there ready for you. Let us see what else he's telling you. It says, the uncircumcised and the defiled will not enter you again. Do you see this? He's promising you that the uncircumcised and the defiled will not enter you again. This is a promise over your life. As you say, as you cry out to Yeshua, would you help me? I don't know this God. I don't know much about Him. I am not even a Christian. I don't know about any of it. But would you please help me in this situation? If that is your heart's cry today, He's promising you that no more the devourer will devour you. No more the destroyer will crush you, because you and your household is covered by the blood of Yeshua. I claim it. Every person who is listening to me, oh Father, cover us. Cover us with the blood of Yeshua. No more the uncircumcised. No more the defiled. No more the destroyer is going to enter my household in the name of Yeshua. Destroyer, be out. The pangs of devil, be destroyed in the name of Yeshua. Every plan that stands up against us, let it be destroyed in the name of Yeshua Mashiach. Would you just declare that over your lives? Yes, His word says that it has got the power to demolish every stronghold, bring down every plan, pretension or argument that stands up against His will, and take every thought captive to His word, to Christ Yeshua. Can we declare it over our lives today, that the word is demolishing every stronghold that has been pulling us down? In the name of Yeshua, it is destroyed today. Every plan, every pretension, everything that the devil planned to destroy us and our families and our household, destroy you and your family and your household, is demolished from the root in the name of Yeshua. Declare over your life. Can you speak it out with me again? The power of the word is demolishing every stronghold in my life. Say that again. The power in the name of Yeshua is demolishing every stronghold in my life. He is destroying every plan, every pretension, every argument that the devil has put in my life in the name of Yeshua. And he is taking away every negative feeling, every weakness, every anxiety, every worry, every sickness captive. His word says that he has given you the authority to trample over snakes and scorpions and to overcome all the powers of darkness, and nothing is going to harm you. Nothing is going to harm me. He has given me the authority to trample over snakes and scorpions and to overcome all the powers of darkness. This is his word. This is his word. He's not a man to lie, but he's true to his promises, my dear. He's true to his promises. Would you just receive this? No more the uncircumcised and the defiled and the devourer and the destroyer is going to come to your life. No more, because the doors of my house are closed for you. The blood of Yeshua has been put on the doorpost, and we are covered by the blood of Yeshua. Can you declare that over your life today? And then it says, shake off your dust, rise up, sit enthroned, O Jerusalem. You know what? For almost, I think for 18, till the time I was 18, 19, I always had this feeling that I am not good for anything. And every time if you look at my face, there would be that sadness on my face, and there would be that confusion on my face. You could read it out from my face that, you know, I'm not confident about myself. But when the love of the Maker came into my heart, when I found this Father's love, when I realized that the Maker of this heaven and earth is my Father, and in Him I am complete, I understood that I have a Father. I have a Father to protect. My earthly father left me, but my heavenly Father covered me. And I'm still under that cover. And today I am welcoming you. I am welcoming you under the wings of this Father. You might think that it is an imagination. No, my dear brother. No, my dear sister. It is not an imagination. It is true. The God that I'm talking to you about, He is living, and He wants to cover you. He wants to give you the love of the Father. He wants to give you the protection of a mother. He wants to give you the care of a mother. He wants to give you the protection of a father. Would you just receive that? Would you just receive that? Yes. And it says that shake off your dust. So far you were living in that emptiness. You were living in that feeling of wastedness. You know, you feel that your life has been a waste so far, and you are living in that filth and in that dust. You compare yourself with people around and you feel that I am nowhere there. Oh, they all have such wonderful lives. They have money, they have cars, they have bungalows. My friends have everything. And here I worry to buy a single notebook for me to get that much money enough to pay my one-time fees. Or one-time food I don't have. And you think, I am not there anywhere. You live in the dust of your life, where you think that is only what you can deserve. That is where you are going to stay. No, dust. Just shake it off. Shake off that dust and rise up in the name of Yeshua. And it says, rise up and sit enthroned. So it says, rise up. Get up. Get up. Yes, get up. And says, sit enthroned. Know who you are. You are the daughter of the Most High, my dear. You are the son of the Most High. You know that He is your Father. And when you know that, you have a big Father. The one who created the heaven and earth is your Father. Now don't stoop. Don't feel bad about yourself. Get up. Let there be change in your body posture itself. You see how kings sit on a throne? Just think about that. Think about it. You have a throne. and the throne is that of a prince, the throne of a princess. You are the daughter of the Most High. You are the daughter of the Most High, my dear. Yes, sit enthroned. Let your position change. Even if you don't see anything in the real realm, even if you don't see anything around, get up. Feel that pride in you. I'm not saying be proud of who you are. I'm not saying take pride in what you have. I'm not saying take pride in your capabilities. I'm saying take pride in the knowledge that I am the daughter of the Most High, and the maker of this heaven and earth loves me and he has come to me. So be enthroned, O Jerusalem. Free yourselves from the chains on your neck, O captive daughter of Zion. So far there were so many chains on you. Rules, regulations, rituals, and so many things that bound you. Relationships, responsibilities. I'm not saying get rid of your responsibilities. I'm not saying get rid of your lifestyle. But what I'm saying is that get rid of the burden that has been put on you because of those. Let those be taken off in the name of Yeshua. You have the chains on, but you have two hands. Raise it to heaven and take off the chains. You have to use your chains to take it off, right? You have a chain on you. So I have a chain here. It is there in my neck, right? This chain I will have to open. Nobody else is going to come and open it for me. I have to take it and I have to open it. Today I am telling you, use your hands. So I have to use my hand. I have to go, I have to take it and I have to open it. So I'm saying use the same hands to lift your hands above. Lift your hands. Can you do it as a prophetic action right now? Can you lift your hands to heaven and say, Father, would you just break my chains? Would you just take away the chains around my neck? Would you just help me be released from the burdens that are pushing me down, that are pulling me down, that are crushing me? Your raised hands are going to send a deliverance from heaven into your life. And then I would like to come to the end of it. It says, for this is what the word says. Lord says, you were sold for nothing, and without money you will be redeemed. So this is what I want to tell you. That you were sold for nothing, and without money you will be redeemed. Many of you who are hearing me right now, you are suffering not for your mistakes. You are in that bondage or the state not because of what you have done, but many of you are suffering because maybe your family members, your parents, your forefathers have put you into that situation. They might have their own struggles, you have to forgive them. But right now you know that the state that you are in is not because of your mistake. It is because of the mistake of others. Or maybe the sin that you got into. Maybe it could be an addiction that you are into. It could be drug addiction. It could be alcohol. It could be pornography. It could be eating too much. It could be any of it. But you are into that addiction because you were looking for something around. You could not find it in the people around. You cannot get that help. And you directed your attention to these things. Today Yeshua wants to tell you that you were sold for nothing to the devil. Without your mistake. Not because of your mistake. But you are suffering. The devil has put so many things that are called suffering in your life. You were sold for nothing. Your sins, things that have went wrong, all of it. For you're paying price for what you've not done. You are paying a price for what you have not done. And I want to tell you today that the good news is, he says, without money, you will be redeemed. How will you be redeemed? How will you be redeemed from the life of depression, anxiety, worry, sickness, financial crisis, loneliness, addiction? How will you be redeemed? How will you be saved? What is redemption? Redemption is that you pay and get back something. You redeem it. You have to give something to redeem it. And that is what I want to tell you. Nobody is there to pay for your sins. Nobody is there to pay for your sufferings. Nobody is going to come and write a one crore check to you and say that, oh, come out, you who are heavy laden with burdens of, you know, of debts. No, nobody is going to come and write a check to you, right? Maybe that can happen also, okay? That can also happen. Somebody is going to write a check for you and tell you that I want you to come out that debt, of that debt. That happens in the kingdom of God. That does happen. But today I want to tell you that greater is the redemption that is there in Christ. Christ redeemed you of your sins, of your generational curses, bondages, and everything that you're going through. Without anything, you were sold. You have suffered enough and you have wasted your life. You were sold for nothing to the devil's kingdom. But without money, without anything, the Maker shed his blood on the cross that you will be redeemed out of it, that I will be redeemed out of it. I am redeemed out of it. And my brother and my sister, I want to tell you that you are redeemed from the life of sickness and sin in the name of Yeshua. In the name of Yeshua. Would you just declare it? Would you just say, my Redeemer lives. My Redeemer lives. My Redeemer lives. Could you just declare that over your lives? Yeshua is your Redeemer. Yeshua is my Redeemer. Yeshua is the Redeemer of your parents. Yeshua is the Redeemer of your husband. Yeshua is the Redeemer of your wife. Yeshua is the Redeemer of your children. Would you just declare it? Would you just declare it? Without anything, you were sold. But without money, without the things of the world, by the blood of Christ, you will be redeemed. You are redeemed. You are redeemed. So this day, I have only one thing to say. Awake from your sleep. Awake from your emptiness. Awake from your weakness. Awake from your depression. Away from your worry. Awake from your disturbance. Get up. Get up from your sleep. Open your eyes and see that the Maker of the heaven and earth wants to come and help you. His word, His spirit wants to help you. Let the eyes of your heart open. Let your heart be awake in the name of Yeshua. Let every heart be awake today and let them know that there is help available. All you have to do is awake. Get up, get up, get up and wear the clothes that Yeshua wants to give you. The torn clothes, the clothes of past, the clothes of sin, of sickness and shame that you wore. He's tearing it off today and He has given you a new uniform, a new dress, a cloth of splendor. Receive it in the name of Yeshua. And He's telling you that no more the devourer will devour you. No more the devourer will devour me. The word says that by the blood of Christ, I have been redeemed by the futile ways of life inherited from my forefathers. I repeat it. The word very clearly says in Peter, it says, the word says like this, that I have been redeemed by the blood of Christ from the futile ways of life inherited by my forefathers. Doesn't matter how your forefathers were. Doesn't matter how your parents were. Doesn't matter you are 60 years old. Doesn't matter that you have come halfway your life. No, it doesn't matter. Still, my Yeshua is able to give you a new life and a new beginning. Can you receive that in the name of Yeshua today? Receive it, my dears. This is the prophecy over your life. I don't have big things to tell you. I don't want to tell you that you will get a lot of money in your bank account. Of course, you will get it when your need is. But what I want to tell you is that there is ready help available for you. All you have to do is let your heart open up and receive this truth in your life. I want to close and pray now. and anybody, doesn't matter where you have been, what you have done, what is your caste, what is your tribe, what is your life, what is your position. No, none of it. None of it. I don't want to think about any of it. But I just want to know, or I just want to tell you, that you are a child of Yeshua. Even before you were born in your mother's womb, He saw you. And today, at this point, when you think of finishing your life, He wants to tell you that He loves you and that He's going to redeem you if only you believe. If only you believe the Redeemer is at your doorstep. This is close. Father, we thank you for this time in your presence. Father, not me, but let your will be done. I pray for my dear brother and sister who's listening to me. Let your blessings flow through into the lives of your children. Father, your word says that you shed your blood on the cross, that we will be redeemed from our sinful life, from our bondages. And it is not a man, but it is you who have said it. In the name of Yeshua, I pray that let your word bring healing, bring redemption from sin and from shame and sickness and anything that is holding your children back. Yes, Father, I pray for your hand of grace to cover them. I pray that every word that I spoke to them right now, it is not Raji who is speaking. It is you and your spirit that is going to work into their lives. Help them get up. Get up from the place of sleep. Help them get up and wear the clothes, Father. Wear the clothes, O Master, of your splendor, of your goodness, O Master. Let them realize that they are your children, that they are not ordinary people, but they are the children of the Most High God, and that you have come to redeem them. Father, I declare over their lives the power in the name of Yeshua and the blood of Yeshua over each and every person, O Father. And I pray that let your name be glorified through this. I pray that let testimonies arise, O Father. Let testimonials arise in the lives of your children, O Master. I give you all the glory and honor. In Yeshua's name I pray. Amen. 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 My dear brother and sister, one last time, I just want to tell you, awake from your place. Open your eyes, receive the word into your heart, and see the miracle that is going to happen in your life. Yeshua's blessings to you. May I hear that this has been a blessing to you.